Riddle me this. What do you get if you take Super Meat Boy, strip it down to bare necessary minimum of its existence, and apply one new mechanic to make your game different? Growing pains. And it's painfully bland. It's a very basic clone of Super Meat Boy, which means it's a fast-paced, precision platformer full of deadly traps. The twist I mentioned a few seconds ago? Your character, this porcupine, maybe? Keeps on growing all the time, so you must finish the level before you block yourself in. Each level is broken into segments in which you need to collect the default Photoshop rainbow gradients before processing further. You control your character very similar to Meat Boy. You have your wall jumps, wall slides, regular jumps, and you dodge spikes, lasers, and other hazards. The difference is that the controls are much more stiff. You don't gain the ridiculous momentum and speeds that Meat Boy does, which makes the character feel a bit sluggish. One additional mechanic is that you can bounce off the ground to achieve a higher jump, but I rarely use this ability, and hell, often I'd use it unintentionally just to bounce myself into spikes. You can also force your character to grow so he can traverse some parts easier and faster, but again, growing is more of an inconvenience than a hazard. More often, I had to force myself to grow rather than wait for it to happen. You'll die more from spikes than growing out of your pajamas. And spikes, oh boy. Remember how in Super Meat Boy everything works in perfect sync and resets once you die? Yeah, not here. While most spikes and lasers have a regular pattern that can be memorized, there are these annoying little cannons which basically behave randomly, meaning no two runs can be replicated as you have to look out. You also need to remember to keep an eye on your lives as they are limited. But, like I said, the rest of the hazards in-game aren't so challenging. It's far from the difficulty level of SMB. Moving on to other bland things. The graphics and level design. The game has basically no charm, no character, and looks more of a prototype of a game. Referencing Super Meat Boy again, which had multiple characters with unique personality, each having their own respective world, theme music, everything. Here it's just a single colored world. Absolutely zero variety exists. Not to mention the game has only 9 levels. That's a pretty low number. Of course, there are 3 difficulties that you unlock by beating the previous one for each level, but it's almost the same level, so why bother? It's as simple as it looks. There's basically not much to it. It tries to mimic the slick controls and gameplay of Super Meat Boy, but in the end, it controls far less enjoyable and misses its mark.